एक टाइम था व्हेन एवरीबॉडी वुड लैप अप एनीथिंग प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द एमसीयू और द डीसीईयू, बट लाइक ऑल गुड थिंग्स दैट केम टू एन एंड एंड नाउ एनी मूवी इन द जॉनरा इज अ बिट ऑफ अ स्विंग. डिड वी रियली नीड अ शज़ाम पार्ट 2? आई मीन Hey all, my name is Sucharita. Welcome back to my channel where we talk about movies and occasionally with movie makers as well. Today we're talking about Shazam, Fury of the Gods. Okay, if you're a little thrown by my opening statement, let me make it clear up front. I fully enjoyed this film. So maybe one didn't need a Shazam movie with Helen Mirren and Lucy Liu playing Atlas ki daughters. But am I mad at it? No. $15 deke kharidi maine ticket, but maze to aa gaye. Swedish director David F. Sandberg returns. Is bar Billy Batson and his foster siblings, full-on Philadelphia crime fighters, ban gaye hain. They're saving people from falling off of bridges and they're stopping burglaries, Shazamming all over the place. Until Atlas ki teen betiyan arrive to strip everyone of their powers, steal a golden sabre, which is the seed of life they need for their realm to become prosperous again. You know the usual. In case the only thing you remember from the first Shazam is Zachary Levi's disarming smile, I don't judge you. While that film was cute, it certainly wasn't the most memorable. But I will recommend you do some light reading to refresh the plot in your mind before watching the second one. Like the last one, once again, the best thing about this movie is Zachary Levi's disarming smile. But this time, actor Jack Dylan Grazer, who plays Freddie Freeman, gets to do a whole lot more, a lot of screen time. This gifted 19-year-old lights up the screen, if I may use a cliche, shining brighter than a mildly worried-looking Rachel Zegler, who shares the most screen time with him.
I just threw a truck at a dragon. I love my life.
You know, the most charming thing about the Shazam movies is that the adults, they're actually, like, they have to be children, right? Navigating the world with superpowers, which fully grown people aren't even equipped to use. This enhances the movie's likability because even during the most high-stakes fight scenes, Zachary Levi is playing a 17-year-old slaying demons without training or instruction. In the haphazard lies the cute. Also delightful is Helen Mirren saying the most outlandish lines as Atlas's oldest daughter and lifting a fully grown man over her head before smashing him down into the ground. Not every day you get to see a 77-year-old woman do that. Love. So, spot some Easter eggs, chuckle at some silly jokes, lean into the magic. We have an enchanted library, self-writing pens, a cyclops, tree of life, skittle-eating unicorns. This movie might not be a Black Panther in its cultural impact, a Shang-Chi in its cultural reset, or even Ant-Man in its star power, but it is a damn sight better than whatever Black Adam was supposed to be. Dear Lord, I'm going to reshare my review of that awful, awful movie. Please watch it if you haven't. The review, don't watch the movie. Unlike Black Adam, this movie realizes the easiest way to become endearing is to not take itself seriously and run with it. So you get a ton of gags, some things even a 17-year-old is too old to say in the face of imminent death, to be honest with you. And steadfastly, the movie refuses to make an effort to stand out in any spectacular or even noticeable way. The director is known for making small-budget horror films, and Fury of the God feels like a small-budget superhero film. Some portions could be an SNL sketch, to be honest. The lighting, editing, set design, they're all just that basic.
It doesn't matter. Anyway, the wizard gave me superpowers.
But eventually, it works. Not as something you might recommend to a friend to definitely go watch, but as a Sunday date night movie when you momentarily want to feel like you live in a world where inside your room is even a more secret room within which is another room with a million doors which open up to a million rooms when you can escape anywhere you want.
It's all about
So on a scale of 1 to 10, Shazam! The Fury of the Gods is 8 episodes. Zachary Levi appeared in a few years ago in a beloved Amazon Prime TV series as a love interest. Comments mein batao kaun sa show tha wo? Oh, should I start doing a pop culture quiz like this at the end of each review? I think I will. What fun. Agli quiz kya hogi? Uske liye subscribe kar lo. Channel ko dosto hain. Click karo yahan par. Subscribe button should pop up right here. My name is Sucharita. Thank you for stopping by.